Hello, and welcome to this course on test-driven development. My name is Matt Greencroft, and I'm going to be guiding you through the process of test-driven development on this course. Because I'm going to be saying the words test-driven development a number of times, I'm going to just abbreviate it to TDD. So TDD is not a new idea. It's been around since 2003 and is an important part of agile programming. If you practice TDD and you do it consistently and thoroughly, then it promises to guide you to write clean code that works. Test-driven development is a practice that comes from extreme programming. Extreme programming is a way of writing code that complies with the Agile Manifesto. So many people associate TDD with Agile. Or in other words, if you're working in an agile way, then you should be doing TDD. However, unless you're starting a project from scratch, writing code using TDD can present some challenges. More often than not, we're asked to amend or enhance code that is part of an existing project where TDD has not been used. So we're going to look at how you might approach this type of very common situation later on in the course. But we will need to cover the basics first. I wanted to point out, I suppose, that this course really should be called Practical TDD, because in addition to explaining the process that is required to carry out TDD, we're going to be focusing on the reality of how you can create unit tests, what kind of challenges you might meet along the way, and how to overcome them. So we'll make a start in this chapter by understanding what is really meant by test-driven development. I'm going to assume that you have a development environment such as Eclipse set up with Java installed. That's all you need to be able to do this course. You can use any development environment you like. I'm going to be using Eclipse. Test-driven development means that we use tests to drive the writing of our code. In general, there's a workflow which we use, which is normally described as red-green refactor. Red means that we'll be writing tests of business logic that we expect initially to fail. They'll fail because we haven't yet written any code to make the test pass. Green means that we'll write code or correct code so that our tests pass. And then refactor means that once we have our tests passing, we'll be able to refactor our code and our tests to make them more efficient. As we'll see, each of these three steps have their own set of rules or mini-steps to follow, and we're going to be going through these in lots of detail in the coming chapters. For now, something that is important to understand is that as we develop the functionality for our applications, we're going to be writing tests first before we write any code to make the tests pass. And this is going to be an iterative process. Each piece of functionality could require us to write a lot of tests. We're going to see why this is helpful as we progress through the course. Before we leave this chapter, I want to just talk a little about what we will be writing tests for and what we won't be writing tests for. In general, we want to be writing tests that check a single identifiable piece of logic or behaviour. This is a unit of functionality that we want to test, hence the phrase unit testing. We want to test single units of functionality in isolation. So we won't be wanting to write tests that would check the validity of an end-to-end process, for example. Now, of course, you might well want to do that for other reasons. You'd probably call those integration tests, but it's not part of test-driven development, and we're not going to be doing those in this course. Actually, looking at this, what are we going to test, we do need to go a little bit deeper. We're going to have multiple tests for a single piece of logic. Each will be testing different scenarios that are needed to make up this logic. Again, we'll see what this means in practice very soon. So each test should test one piece of logic only, and in fact a single scenario for that piece of logic. The idea is that by creating a suite of tests, testing different scenarios, then we'll test all the likely different combinations of logic. Okay, well, that's been quite a bit of talk, quite a bit of dry theory, and I think it's best if we learn hands-on. So we'll start doing that in the next chapter, where we're going to be setting up our environment, starting off a brand new project, and then we'll be ready to write tests and understand what all of this means. So I'll see you in chapter 2.